innovator, visionary, genius. These words all describe our next recipient. Moses Znaimer set out to change the face of television, and he succeeded. Let's take a look at the life of Moses Znaimer.
I started in radio. I suddenly found myself producing a national program, and it is still on the air. It is cross-country checkup. It's like the world's first national open line show. Had an education and philosophy. People think, you know, I went to Harvard, so they all assume I went to the business school. I didn't. I may be the only guy who came out of Harvard that people know who didn't go to the business school. I studied philosophy and government and political theory, so the language of money was very new to me. And I spent two very intense years trying to get a grip on that. And then the CRTC announced that it was going to receive applications for new stations in the Toronto area. We got the license in November of 71, and I started the company as the first employee on January 1st, 1972. We went on air in September. I had this big insight. They're all shot in studios. Studios look the same, doesn't matter where they are. So if you want to show difference, you have to escape the studio. And since I didn't have the money for the studio, that was easy. And you have to start shooting in the street. Wow, what's more real than the street? We developed videography in a way that I think predated even the arrival of the equipment. We tried to shoot all electronic from the very beginning. Never owned a film camera, never owned film development labs. Conventional television was about the great cliches, and so I thought I didn't want to speak that language. What do people, young people especially, do with themselves? They go to the movies, they listen to music. In the music and the movies, they find their fashion, and that in turn becomes the culture of the street. So that's what I decided to do. Les longs métrages was my entertainment delivery, and then we began these specialized programs in popular culture, like fashion television, movie television, media television, book television. City eventually begat Much, and Match begat Plus, and Plus begat Max, and on and on and on. Because people assumed that we were only good at youth and rock and roll, I decided to show them, no, we're good at TV. Kevin, what you want it to be? J'étais ravi à ce moment de l'idée d'une vidéo-vérité parce que j'ai vu beaucoup de ces films de Nouvelle Vague de France, de cinéma-vérité, mm. Et j'ai voulu sortir dans la vie réelle. And then you wake up and it's 30 years later, and instead of one channel, there's 25. I don't live in a woulda, shoulda life. I think in the moment is where I find myself, and I don't have trouble being there. I don't spend a lot of time. In fact, I spend almost no time in the past. I do spend a fair amount of time in the future, but I see the future as optimism, that a world of possibilities. One of my little struggles as a professional has been to, evoke the idea that it's possible to do television in an artful way. I've always tried to do it artfully, and I was very happy to have TV recognized not just as a corporate medium, but as an artistic medium. Engagé, ça c'est moi. Bingo. Voilà mon histoire.